SM Investments and SM Prime announcing the creation of a $3 billion European medium-term note program. The C Group says the move, previously reported in April, will allow it to tap the offshore bond market for funding of its growth and expansion. And in earnings this morning, DMCI reports a 25% drop in its first quarter profit. Net income stood at 5.6 billion pesos on lower contributions from most of its businesses. Now, net earnings, meanwhile, were up to 4.7 billion pesos. That's nearly double its pre-pandemic level. GoTime has acquired the Philippines' biggest salary lender. The Gokongwei's digital bank announced Tuesday its stakeholders, JG Summit and GoTime, or Time Group, have bought Savvy. Now, it adds the acquisition will help it sell more payroll-enabled loan products and boost its path to profitability.
GoTime Bank's ambition is to become the largest consumer retail bank in the country. And I think if you really want to be effective in that space, you have to get into payroll relationships. And I think what makes it that a bit trickier than most markets around the world is that in the Philippines, 99% of employees don't actually choose their payroll account, right? The corporate dictates it. So while we actually have a payroll offering, we've been getting some good traction early on, that B2B sales cycle is very slow, right? Enter Savvy, who has had an incredible track record over the last 7 years. They've, Liam and team have signed up over 170 corporates, have access to over 500,000 salaried employees with their lending proposition. So we're very excited to kind of combine the consumer banking proposition that's leading from GoTime with the lending proposition and the relationships they have.
The Marcos administration secures the commitment of the Intergovernmental Finance Institution OPEC Fund to address right-of-way acquisition issues in its big-ticket infrastructure projects. Such issues are said to hinder the construction of key infra projects, including the Metro Manila subway. The finance department announced Tuesday that OPEC Fund made that commitment on the sidelines of the World Bank International Monetary Fund spring meetings in Washington, D.C. in April. There, OPEC Fund also expressed interest in funding the Public Financial Management Reform Program, which aims to ensure the effective delivery of public services, especially for the poor. The Philippines makes its return to the international bond market. It announced on Tuesday the issuance of dual tranche U.S. dollar bond offering, the first under the Marcos administration this year, which has a tenor of 10 years and a 25-year sustainability tranche. The initial price guidance for the 10-year tenor is set around the level of Treasuries plus 120 basis points. Now, the 25-year sustainability bond, meanwhile, is set around 6.05%. The proceeds of the bond issuance will be used for general budget financing. Finance Secretary Ralph Recto told Bloomberg, government is seeking to raise as much as $2 billion from the bond sale. He added the offer is part of a plan to raise about $5 billion in funding from overseas markets for the year.